All right. Okay, here's Grandma Michelle, and she's talking to this really good-looking gentleman, as you see in this video. I saw him earlier here at the Portrait Gallery in D.C. He was downstairs, and he was eating, and I was in the courtyard. And it was because of him that I walked into that courtyard at that particular time. I didn't go over to him then, and then he left, and then another wonderful incident occurred, and I met these lovely two young people that took the video you see earlier. Then I left them, and then I continued to go into the gallery, the three floors on it, and on the third floor, there was coffee, free coffee, and I was very surprised at the free coffee and very happy because I was thinking after this I was just going to go to a Starbucks or any coffee shop and get a cup of coffee. But then I saw that same gentleman sitting over at a table by himself reading a book, and I said I needed to go over there and speak to him because he's someone special and see if he'll talk to me. Yes, David, that's his name, someone special. And David agreed to be videotaped. And David, how about you telling your story about you now, your age? You want to tell your age?
56. Homeless since 2003, as I've already told you. Been here in D.C. since 2006.
And would you like to tell them why you're homeless now?
The usual. Job got exported overseas. And a computer programmer. Job disappeared. And been bumming along. Been a security guard. I've been a clerk in a courthouse in Fort Lauderdale, Broward County Courthouse, and doing our jobs. The longest was as an armed security, then came here to D.C., and this was at the height of the recession, and forget about getting any jobs. So I've just kind of been living in the shelter and staying in the shelter.
Where is the shelter?
In Northeast section, where all the bums hang out. It is a what they call a low barrier emergency shelter for men only. There are three of them. There's also for women, but I'm not sure. I only know one of them. There are three of them that are run by the D.C. government. And are you recording all this?
Absolutely. This is on. Okay. This is very important to me.
All I'm seeing is a blank over here.
That's okay.
There are three of them, and there's one by the federal government, CCNV. I'm with the smallest one run by the D.C. government. It's all kinds of rough types. It's for older men like myself, and we're kind of a lot of Vietnam veterans are there who are bummed out. I mean, we get all kinds of stories.
Well, I understand that. I work with vets, and I know that, and I know PTSD and where their head is at, and
a lot of
dysfunctionality, right, because of that.
A lot of drug abusers are trying to crawl out. It's a tough life, but hey, nobody put a gun to my head to stay in this thing. I mean, if I wanted to, I suppose I can get a job someplace doing something. But then, of course, you run into the situation. This is one of these catch-22. You become one of the working poor, where you will get just enough to not get any benefits, but not earn enough to live anywhere. So you get yourself into a situation, where you are just working to pay taxes and nothing else, but you have no benefits. This way, by not having any work, at least I get some benefits. I get food stamps, stuff like that, that if I was working, I would be ineligible for.
Okay.
And this way, at least I get a rent-free place that is semi-safe. So.
Okay, so what are you looking to do? Are you looking to get out of this situation to something else? You told me that you're an artist. Talk about that for a minute.
If I spell it out to you, you'll be able to listen to it. Okay. epiphanygospelart.weebly.com epiphanygospelart.weebly.com. Weebly.com is a free website. It allows you to create free web pages. You go over there and you will see what kind of art we do. It's every Sunday. It's a historical church. It's over 100 and some years old, just down the road over here by the White House. They have breakfast for the homeless every Sunday morning.
So that's where you're going tomorrow?
And that's where, yes.
And is that where your art is?
That's where the art is. Before and after breakfast, they have an hour before and about an hour and a half.
What time is that?
The breakfast is after church. It starts at around 9:30. So between 7 o'clock and 8 o'clock, then everything stops. They open up. You don't have to go into the church. You don't have to be part of the service. They accept of any denomination or no denomination. You can be anybody off the street.
Okay.
But they stop, and from 8 until about 8:45, they have church service. And then every Sunday, it's a hot breakfast from about 8:45 till about 9:30, and then gospel art starts again. And we do artwork. You work with paints, you work with drawing, with pencils, with clay. You work with anything you like. You do poems, you do storytelling. People write their biographies, and we post it on the web so that everybody can see it. We even had took some of the best paintings, best artwork, and we created 16 greeting cards. Again, non-denominational, so even if you're Jewish, you're Muslim, whatever, you can use these same cards, you know, greeting cards. You can send them out at Christmas. And that's used to pull in money to help with defer the cost of doing breakfast for the homeless. So that's that story right there.
And
if you'd like to see, that's where you see me.
Yeah, that's I might just show up tomorrow.
Oh, yeah.
I might just show up tomorrow. You never know.
Oh yeah, you'll see me over there. The
that'll
lady
be
who runs it, her name is Marge,
and right.
She's a wonderful person.
I might
very low key. And the breakfast is free.
I need to ask you, where else do you find nourishment to eat your food? Your food to sustain you?
That's
important.
You get on the street. That government doesn't give you. What they do is they give the men a place to sleep at night from 7 p.m. till 7 a.m. 7 a.m., I don't care what it's like, snow, rain, hurricane, bright, beautiful sun, it doesn't matter. You're out of there at 7. And from 7 a.m. till, again, 7 p.m., you're on the street. So most of the time, you're hung up on finding food.
There is no free food anywhere?
On the street. On the street. People will bring food sometimes. People will won't. They have places like Soam. It's kind of violent, but they will give you free food.
What's that place? What do you mean?
Okay, that is Soam, S-O-M-E. It stands for So Others Might Eat. It is a semi-private, yeah, have your coffee before it goes cold. It's a semi-private organization here in D.C. that will give you free breakfast and free lunch, but it's kind of violent.
What do you mean violent? Why?
Knife. There are a lot of people, a lot of criminals that go there to get free food.
And so where is that?
It's here in the north, in the, well, actually it's right, it's off of North Capitol, which is the divider between the northeast and northwest is North Capitol. And it's just over on the northwest side.
How are you able to survive all these years without an incident of someone hurting you? Obviously, you're okay and you haven't been harmed, or have you been harmed at times?
I don't allow that to happen. I keep very, very low key, and I'm pretty big. So people leave me alone.
Okay, how tall are you? Well, let's see, why don't you stand up? Why don't you stand up for my audience? Let's let them see how big and tall you are. Okay, oh my goodness, let's see. Okay, let's see. All right, I'm gonna move out here and we can see just what David looks like. All right, that's great. Okay. All right, so we'll sit back down and we're going to end this right now a bit because 11 minutes is enough on YouTube, because otherwise it becomes too boring for people. They can't stay focused as we do. So on with my day, and I will see David probably tomorrow at this church thing.
Epiphany.
Yes.
Down the road on G Street.
Down the road on G Street. So thank you very much for telling me your story, David, and good luck to with whatever you do, and God bless you for whatever you want will come about. Trust me, but it's what you want. I don't know what you want. You'll tell me.